What's up, everyone? So some very, very interesting and cool news. Free stuff's always good. But big news, basically, in virtualization coming out, that VMware has essentially decided to make both VMware Fusion and VMware Workstation both free for everyone. And that includes commercial users. Up until recently, both of the desktop hypervisors came with a price tag, a pretty hefty one too, but Fusion ran for macOS and Workstation was the go-to for Windows and for Linux users. Now, whether you're an educator, a business, or, you know, just experimenting at home, both of these tools are actually available to you for free. But that kind of begs the question, you know, why does it matter and what's the difference actually between them? Well, first, a hypervisor, simply put, is software that basically allows you to run multiple virtual machines or VMs on one piece of hardware. That means you could run, say, a Linux system inside your Windows on your Windows PC. Each of these has a pro version, which essentially is like a more feature-packed edition for those power users that are out there. Now, previously, VMware had charged a lot of money for this. Fusion Pro was like $200 or something for a license, and Workstation Pro was even more at, you know, $250. Now, this new move means no more subscription costs, which is always nice. All the features that used to be locked behind the paywall are now open to everyone. The only catch is that there's no more official support ticketing. So while you get all the features, if things break, you're pretty much on your own or relying on community forums. For those wondering, me personally, I don't really like VMware. I like VirtualBox. I think open source is when it runs on pretty much anything. And in my experience, it's just easier to work with. But I can't deny that VMware's tools are absolutely solid in terms of performance, especially if you're, you know, doing super complex networking setup or enterprise level testing, which I've never actually done. The hope here is that VMware's shift to free isn't just like some kind of temporary get people into their ecosystem, you know, kind of thing, that this could make it easier for more people to learn virtualization, which is a skill that's in fairly high demand. And it's absolutely useful, even if we're just looking at it from a security perspective. But one interesting point is that this move comes just after some changes at VMware. One of those things was getting a new owner. Broadcom, which has already ended perpetual licensing for other products and discontinued the free version of the vSphere hypervisor, Broadcom says that they will keep developing new features for Fusion and Workstation, which is a positive sign, right? I mean, the fact that they're continuing development and they're going to give it to you for free is pretty awesome. And by the way, no one sponsored this. No one's paying me to say any of this. I just figured, you know, free things are pretty awesome. So let's just hope that they actually stay true to their word and keep updates rolling out for free, right? If you're a fan of virtualization or need to run a VM for testing, I would definitely take advantage of the software. I mean, it's free, right? It's fully featured desktop hypervisors for free, you know, don't always come around all that often. For me personally, I like VirtualBox, and that's just personal preference and my love for open source in general. However, it's all up to you. And at the end of the day, getting experience with different things isn't going to hurt. If anything, it'll help. So that's what I definitely advise people to at least go check it out now that it's free. Not that I had ever used it before by downloading it from places like IPTorrents. I'm not a fan of it. So we'll just leave it at that, right? In any case, I hope you guys are doing well today, and I'll see you in the next video.